Hi guys, I'm Jenna McCohen and I am Marlene's sister. Today I am subbing for her and she's actually filming this. She's not feeling too well, so I'm going to give you your Parent Tip Tuesday. This is Picasso, as you all know, and he is actually molting. And the way you know a bird is molting is, come up, step up, step up. Let's show them, yeah, let's show to the camera. Oh, his nail got stuck on my shirt. Come on, step up, is by, you see the little feathers growing and the new feathers growing in on top. And obviously he can't physically pluck his head. And this is my first time seeing a bird molt. It's actually very cool. He does look a little, you know, banged up, but it's totally normal. His feathers are actually sensitive. Could be a little irritating or itchy for him, so he does take a bath in his water bowl every single day. A reason birds molt is to get a brand new feathers each year, and that's for, you know, for flight, that's for having more vibrant feathers to attract a mate, and also, of course, to keep them in conditions of when it's cold weather or hot weather to keep their thermostat normal. And on top of that, they keeps them waterproof. So I don't know if you guys have ever noticed, if you put a drop of water on a bird, it'll just slide right off. Another thing is, you should know, is their feathers drop symmetrically. So if one feather on this wing drops, the same exact feather will on the other side, so they can grow at the same time, and when it's time for him to fly, he's totally able to and it's totally balanced. Picasso's definitely a little cranky, and which is normal because they get mood swings. He doesn't really like to be pet or snuggled as much. He just wants to be in his own little spot and sit next to you. He does prefer to sleep in a little bit of more dark areas. And we're giving him his space right now because we don't want to irritate him too much. Like right now, this is all he wants to do all day. And you may think like maybe he's a little bit more down or sad, and it's just his way of keeping himself like, I need to go through this time. Another thing is, you should remember, is feeding him a little bit more healthier, 25% healthier, you know, giving him more food, more time to be on his own, or maybe he'll even want to hang out with you. You don't know. Maybe he needs more attention. I don't know. I'm going to ask Marlene, is there anything else you think I should say, add on to this?
Well, yeah, I think you went over everything. But yeah, I try to spend more time with Picasso when he's molting because he tends to get a little bit depressive, but a little less touching him because feathers can be extremely sensitive, which you went over. And the 25% is kind of like 25% more food, like he might eat more than normal. And he takes baths because they need to have like some moisture in their feathers. So it's recommended that you spray them down. But I think Picasso's so smart, he takes care of himself. He has like a bath in his bowl. And of course, you make sure that you always change that water. And things like that.
Yeah, as far as like his temperament, he's definitely been like, stay away from me. He's kind of, usually he's a very easy bird to, you know, pick up and he'll step up to you. But lately he's been really like, no, leave me alone. This is where I want to be right now. And, you know, he bites you and it's not that it hurts too much, but, you know, he's really standing his ground these days, huh? But he's also very cuddly, so very mood swing. But it's a lot of fun watching, you know, because I know right now he looks a little battered, but I know he's just going to look so much more beautiful in about a few weeks. Actually, right, it happens between 6 to 8 weeks this occurs.
Look, he's got in his trance now.
Oh, did he really?
Yeah.
Cool, on my shoulder?
Yeah. I'm going to stay up close and keep it on the trance because I know people love it.
And I don't know exactly why he does it, but I have a feeling it's his way of like, you know, I learned in school in biology, it's a type of mate attraction.
Yeah.
And it's habit. It's called like a, they do a dance and it's genetic. So like for spiders. If the spider does a certain dance, and it's literally genetic, it goes from generation to generation. And if the spider does one different step, the female spider will eat him and not like mate. But like same things with, the blue-footed ducks. They're called booties or whatever, and they're so cute. They have a specific dance, and it's just genetically, passed down, and they're supposed to attract a mate. So I have a feeling Picasso does that same trans thing to like attract someone. And molting does happen after mating season, and he has been going through a lot of trans like 3 weeks ago. Like he was doing it a lot. Right,
Yeah,
buddy?
that's another thing. Molting can happen one or two times a year. Every species is different. Right, Picasso?
He's cranky.
But when they are about like 8 weeks old, I mean, like 8 weeks old, they'll also, not 8 weeks, sorry. When they're about 8 months old, they'll start their first molt ever because they're getting rid of like their baby feathers. So, every species is different, and sometimes you may not even see the molt. Like on Picasso, we don't usually see the molt this strong as like we do on his head, but you see how the pin feathers are already coming in. That's a clear sign that everything's good and he's healthy and everything like that. I mean, today he already looks so much more beautiful than he did yesterday. And a few other things is that what's the
It's
matter?
okay, you'll get to see mommy soon.
Yeah, he's such a mommy's boy. A few other things to know is that some cockatoos and bigger birds can take much longer to molt. They can take
Yeah.
so long to molt. I've known of people saying like 8 months, and there's bigger birds that are like completely regenerating their feathers and they're getting rid of their like baby feathers or adolescent feathers. And it takes them a long time. So be really patient and be aware that that could be why your bird is moody. It doesn't mean that he doesn't deserve any attention. It just means that he wants to be protective over himself and make sure that, he's not going to be handled in the wrong way. I think we covered everything. I remember a lot more stuff before I made the video, but that's
I
usually how it
think
goes.
definitely, I think you mentioned that some birds will molt twice a year,
Some birds
right?
will molt twice a year. Some birds will have a major molt and then a minor molt. You'll see a lot of feathers at the bottom of your cage. You'll see a lot of feathers all over the place. Don't panic. It's okay. Another way to tell if it's molting or plucking, if the feathers are damaged at the bottom of the cage and they're broken, that is the bird is completely destroying the feathers.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, so. Be aware of that. And sometimes a few feathers just fall out here and there anyway during the season, but they can't completely lose all their feathers at once because they always need to be in able to fly. And that's basically it. Right,
Yeah,
Jenna?
I think so. Definitely leave comments, if you have any questions. I guess I could totally answer any of them and help Marlene out, with comments because I know we get so many of them. I hope you guys are okay with me helping out Marlene today. I love living with the birds, and I'm actually studying to be a veterinarian and aspiring to be an avian specialist. So we'll see where that path takes me. But for right now, I'm gonna be living with my four baby birds and watching Picasso molt. Thank you guys.
Thank you. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, Periscope,
And
Facebook,
subscribe.
and subscribe.
Yay!